Alrighty, what is going on, guys? We are here for week number 3 of our Dallas Cowboys franchise. We have another trade that's actually going to go through. Hopefully, we're trading our backup middle linebacker for a strong safety because we do need a strong safety, and he improves our team by like 7 levels. So we're going to do this, and it should go through because they are really interested. And your trade offer was accepted, so send him to the Cowboys, and we required the Titans pick. So now if we go to our team here, and we look at defense, we're getting stronger and stronger. Where's he at? What position was he again? I forgot, honestly. What was his name? I totally forgot. I know that we needed him, and I know that he helped out the squad. Let me check what his name was. He was a strong safety. Oh, there he is. Yeah, I don't know why he's all the way down here. Oh, he's... Probably should have checked out. He's out for 41 weeks. Well, that sucks. Didn't know he was on the trade block because of it. Alright, it's all good though. So he won't play right away, but we'll have him for next year. And hopefully he's good next year. So we're going to go in. We're playing at Seattle. And we should do the thing. We should do pretty good. 2-0 on the year. We want 4 sacks and 150 rush yards. Sean Lee, he's got 16 tackles on the year. He's actually killing it. The Seahawks are also 2-0. We're going to have to watch out for a couple of their players. I don't know. I think we should have a fairly easy game, though. I'm not trying to underestimate the Seahawks, but week 3 shouldn't be that hard. Zeke, 45 carries for 230 yards this year. That is kind of ridiculous, honestly. David Irving has 9 tackles and 2 forced fumbles on the year. Cole Beasley, 5 receptions for 150 yards. I mean, 105 yards. Doug Baldwin with 19 receptions on the year. Probably leading the league. I just skipped that because it's all good. We don't need to watch it. And we could just get the game going. Part 1's are always super long. I don't want it to be that long. It looks like it is actually raining today, so we're going to have some crazy conditions. Oi, okay, that's not bad. 28. I hate that camera angle though, man. It's actually terrible. Right. I always do this. Let's establish the run game. Alright, we got Bobby Wagner right there on the. He's a right outside linebacker. We also got Earl Thomas to watch out for. We got a couple players that we got to watch out for. Good stop by them there. 2 yards. We are going to attack him in the air this game. A lot of people, they don't attack Seattle because they do have a really good secondary, but I am not afraid. I'm not afraid to do it. I'm going to do it, in fact. Zeke with a nice little catch there to start it off. There we go. See if we could run a plunge. Alright, they're on to they're on to us already on the starting off first down run. So I do not do that. Zeke, man. I mean, hey, if they're going to give us those little checkdowns for 12 yards, 10 yards, I'm perfectly fine with it. I'm not sure that this play was designed for him specifically, but they got through the progressions and got the ball to him. So, second catch on the drive. I just got something added at me. They definitely want him
involved, don't they? Absolutely. This early, the opening drive, as you said, 2 catches. So, if they can get him going in the passing game, it should open up his run.
Oh, he got lit up.
Gets this inside the 35-yard line. Another nice game.
That's messed up, man.
That time and another first
okay.
Down.
I do believe we'll see a little bit more of this as this game progresses.
We're actually shredding
because
them.
Because when you can have that type of a game in the middle of the defense, it hurts them in so many ways. Because
dude, their run defense is so good.
Like to be strong down the middle. If you can sting
that was a nice little run there from Smith. 9 yards.
That's where he, their big tight end, is so good. That middle third, the seam routes, the end routes. Yeah, you're right. Probably see more of that.
Yeah, it takes a lot of courage and fortitude to go in the middle as well. But he's got it.
You're just not going to bring a guy up in the center?
Looking fresh in his own line is definitely licking their chops. Everyone likes
that's a hold.
If you're an offensive
oh,
lineman,
that sucks. Bring it back.
Nice game, too.
Holding offense.
All right, bringing it back. 2nd and 11. Come on, Croft. He is a terrible run blocker.
Each and every year, we talk about very few tight ends coming into the league that are polished.
Are we just going to give Beasley a free touchdown right here? Or is their safety going to affect
him?
Oh! I don't know how Hearns caught that and didn't get tackled, but...
Hey,
I'll take it.
And they're going to face a third down. I don't think it's a surprise they're throwing the football early. We expected that. They told us they were going to come out firing, but 4-for-4 on the opening drive. They like that.
They don't just like it. They love it because now
punk him. Come on. You got to punk him, boy. All right, well, we're going for the field goal again.
And by the way, they're looking at the sideline thinking to themselves and expressing, let's keep throwing it. We're doing pretty well.
And his kick is
money time.
Right,
alright, so we're starting off to a 3-0 lead here. Not terrible. First drive.
So our initial drive this afternoon results
that was the first drive, right?
Not sure
that's
a statement necessarily, but getting points on the road, never a bad thing.
You're exactly right about that. I
Let's
love
get down
how you
there.
Framed it, right? Not sure it's a statement, but at the same time,
good tackle. 22-yard line. Good hold.
Hey, we came to play today.
Chiefs won. Alrighty, let's see. Crawford is out for the year, so we got Woods in there now. Lawrence is going to be our main pass rusher. They actually have some weak matchups. Alright, just punk us on the first play there. Doug Baldwin wide open on the side. This is a team that isn't going to throw the ball a lot. We know that.
It never loses its luster for me. Doug Baldwin.
Oh my. Now, how about that Doug Baldwin catch? Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, buddy. Lock it. Getting lit up. Let's see. Doug Baldwin. Oh, yeah. Doug Baldwin has a good matchup, actually. That's kind
of
scary.
Good to see this man running
great,
again.
Great, great.
Here's Chris Carson. So he loses
to what happened to Chris Carson? Good to see him running again. Did you like break a leg?
Anytime you call an inside running play, you just know there should be a lot of congestion there.
Oh, I totally forgot. I have a calculus homework to do today too.
That didn't happen in this
though.
Case. That play got bottled up.
Now it's Wilson.
Get to him.
Eluding the pressure right. And he's gonna eat this one as down he goes. Sean Lee.
Come on, boy. You know better. You just get bop, bop. I'm letting it go. Yeah. That was almost a really great punt.
Because I think he's found matchups that he likes, and he's capitalizing.
A few times he's even defeated double.
Alrighty, let's actually try to get a touchdown this time.
And let's gaze our attention on Ezekiel Elliott. A tough challenge here in this one. We'll see if he can duplicate the numbers on your screen.
Ha ha. That's a good run there.
We're watching tape to prepare for this game. One thing you noted that I totally agree with. Great complimentary piece in the last game. You know, they're able to throw it pretty well.
Zeke's doing it. Zeke's having a good year. His second game was a lot better than his first, but his first was no.
That's my English teacher right there.
It was no, it was no fluke, you know? It wasn't terrible. It was pretty good, actually.
5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
Bad ambitious.
We
should get this.
Absolutely. What they also understand is that from week to week, it's not necessarily the same, but they want it to be, right? What they saw last week, they want to see this game as well.
And the hole closes quickly.
That's not terrible. 3 yards.
Up to the
we got three, okay? Do not try to tell me that
it's
I didn't
definitely
get three.
Tough to get down. We just
running the option?
Right there, but
ooh.
How about what we did see? Pursuit,
I feel like I should just hand it off no matter what.
The big finish with the tackle.
On third down.
What was that? Why did see like why does he oh Zeke's injured. Uh oh boys. This could be bad.
So on fourth down, here's Chris Jones to punt it away. Back
this better be a weak injury. They just blocked their punt. So Zeke gets injured and then they block our punt. That was Jones' fault. I don't know why it took him so long. Apparently he just can't fucking play. Oh, good.
It's never good when you're
right,
running
it's a terrible
ball,
start. Terrible start.
I see the ball go back behind you. No. Power form, whether it's over your head or to the side, never good.
No. Becomes a race to get to the football so they don't. Jesus, dude. Mystics. Zeke broke his ribs. I gotta bench him. I can't play him on broken ribs. I don't want him to get injured for the rest of the year. Their run defense is really good. I'm not trying to risk anything. Lawrence, tackle him. Well, there it is, boys. We're down 7-3. Off a blocked punt.
First touchdown of the new season, and the Seahawks have taken a first quarter lead. And they're able to run it in. It started with a battle in the trenches. They won.
Come on, baby. We gotta tighten up here. Our defense is playing good. Well, they were playing good. That wasn't really their fault. Bro, go. What the hell? That was so weird. It was like my joystick wasn't working. You're just kind of standing there. Oh, good. We can still run the ball. We just can't run the ball as effective.
So Prescott and the Cowboys now with a 1st and 10 at their own 26. Out of the gun. Here's Prescott. On the left side, he finds Beasley.
4 yards, okay. Throwing these little short routes. Throwing them. They're not going to guard them, not throwing them.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
At least some of that's a first down. I don't think it is. Is it? Yeah, it is. Okay.
His third catch of the afternoon is a first down.
And the tight end is certainly a position built to move the chains because they can control space underneath. If they've got good hands, then of course they're a dynamic target.
I don't really see anything on this play. Right, might have to create something.
Boy. And that makes it easier for the quarterback
nothing.
To pick him out. And
nothing.
On first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down.
All right, Smith, you're a starter. You're going to have to do something, okay, buddy?
On second down, here's Smith.
Go. Damn. All right, that's a good run.
Near the 45-yard line.
Get 8 yards.
Nice job to get 8 there after the incompletion, and now they'll look at a 3rd and 2 coming up.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
And it's a short one here, complete to
yeah.
Start.
I'm telling you, man, they're just giving these little checkdowns. I'll take them. I have no problem with taking these little checkdowns over and over and over until they learn to cover them.
And that one was a lot of fun right there because that was the game within the game. Third and short, blitz was on. What's the key for the quarterback? Get out of your hands in a hurry.
Let's go.
Completion. We got the job done for a first down.
Our pass game is shredding them right now. We're actually shredding them.
They give him 14 yards that time and a fresh set of downs.
When this offense can get their tight ends involved, they can move the football. Here,
I'm going to wait it out a little bit. We'll run one more
play
before the half's over. I mean, before the quarter's over.
A first down carry for Smith.
Oh, my. Talk about getting trucked. He literally just got destroyed, like, terribly.
And they're on the move here. They've got it 1st and 10.
Okay, I like this actually. Depends on how these.
From the red zone now, Prescott flushed out right.
Touchdown.
His throw caught right around the 6.
Here we go, boys. That was a good play.
For a Cowboy touchdown.
Our passing game's strong right now.
Cole Beasley, his first touchdown here of the new campaign. And the Cowboys.
Let's go. Back up 3. That was a nice play. That was a great play actually.
The kickoff unit as they run up and
they tied Oakland and Miami tied. That's funny.
This fielded a few yards into the end zone.
Tackle.
No run back here. This will be a touchback.
Alrighty. Let's get some defense going now. Come on now.
Wilson, the Seahawks take over now. First.
We're really gonna miss Crawford this year, man. That sucks. He started off so good.
They'll start out on the ground with Carson.
Good tackle.
And he will lose yardage here back at the
negative
23-yard line. It's a loss.
Denver and Baltimore tied as well.
Yes, indeed.
Cincinnati, Carolina's 0-3.
I played with to have that suddenness, able to get into the backfield almost about the time the ball snapped and make a play. How about that tackle for a loss?
Absolutely. He did a lot of that last week when he was named the NFC Defensive Player of the Week. One of the guys on the team was saying, hey, we called him the disruptor. And that's
God, man, we can't be letting that happen.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets
we cannot get pass pressure. That was great blocking by him, honestly. What is Sean Lee doing? Get off his booty, bro.
On first and 10, it's Wilson.
Oh, that's such a nice catch. See, I can't be mad about that because that's just a sweet catch. That was an amazing catch. This is going to be an offensive shootout. It's looking like our defense needs to tighten up, man.
And I think it's become more of a glamour position because of the ways it can hurt a defense, and guys want to be involved.
Dude, he's just delivering strikes. Strike after strike, man.
Speed and some toughness to go across the middle. You put it all together, you got a heck of a tight end candidate.
Again, Wilson.
Good.
Taken down, a sack back at the 7.
That I'm struggling to
hold
understand.
Hold a new field goal.
That close to the goal line, first down, run the football. If you want to throw it, throw some play action on second down.
Come on, baby, get him.
He's got to get it running right.
There we go.
Call that a loss of 5 yards on the play.
Dqzzi's dead. I mean, down. Whoa, buddy. Let's hope he's not dead. Third and goal. Here we go.
I want to get this running game going. I'm going down there and saying, gentlemen,
stop him.
We have got to run the football. We've got to get it going right now.
Yeah, to this point in the second quarter, it has been a struggle.
There we go. Good stop.
And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6.
That's what we need to do, boys. That's a huge stop, honestly.
Leads to a fourth and goal.
Well, the strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end and make it a one-on-one play with a cornerback. Who's usually going to win that one?
No! We almost had the block, boys. We almost had it. That would have been a huge block, too. Save the lead.
Good job defensively to hold him to 3.
Yeah, I like how you did that. Give a little tip of the cap to the stop troops there because they didn't give up a touchdown.
I mean, 32. Yeah, that's right. That's 35. That's what I meant. Okay, that's what I meant. I'm still going to run this ball. I don't think that just because Zeke's out, I'm not going to run. I'm just not going to run as much.
And that's effective.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down. Tough running there. That's a hard-earned 4 yards.
Yeah, those are the unsung kind of runs. They don't fill up the stat sheet, but they do set you up in good
he dropped
position
that?
On second down.
No, he caught it. I was about to say.
On the catch. It's
it looked like he dropped it.
Oh, he's got some breathing room.
I think it's okay.
Oh, he's got some breathing room. No, I don't think he does.
Safety valve. This built like
I
this
like
guy.
Smith right
big
here.
Target, guy you can spot pretty easily.
Never mind, no, I don't.
Put it on him when your other targets aren't open.
He'll rifle this one deep right side.
Ah, that's long, Jack. That could have been. That would have been good.
Fourth down now. Something we haven't really seen much of from him. An incomplete pass.
Yeah, last week he finished at 70%. This week he's up over 80%. I don't know how you slow him down. Pass
get there. No! The team wasn't quick enough. That should have been at the 1. Should have been at the 1. Alrighty. Defense has to hold them.
And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I jumped off sides. Jesus, that's terrible. First and 5.
That's going to help him at contract time. But that offense,
jeez, guys, we need to do something. All right, our team's looking weak. We're missing our pass rush out of Crawford.
Sean Lee, the pro
Lawrence isn't doing
tackle.
Anything. He needs to get his 10th tackle. Lawrence having a great year, don't get me wrong. He just isn't doing much yet. This is 10th tackle.
He'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. DeMarcus Lawrence in on the tackle.
And this is why aggressive defense coordinators love to blitz. It wreaks havoc
on,
because
baby.
They end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D linemen to make the play.
They keep it on the ground. This time it's Davis.
And he's got a nice little tackle there. So get it up to about the 28 yard line. They got third and two.
Just a gain of a yard there, and now it'll be third
down. They won't run this.
Whenever we talk about,
I'll throw
the best
a slant to Baldwin or to Lockett, probably
up,
actually.
That's instincts, being able to diagnose runner backs.
They might run like
ops or something. Moves.
He crashed down hard there. He was ready for that running play.
Just got punked, Lawrence. Come on. We should have had that. That was a stop right there. Breaks the tackle.
At this stage of the game, the run pass numbers are a little bit out of whack because most of their yardage has come through the air. But in a sense, that just sets things up for big runs like that because the defense might be a little bit off balance. They pick up another first down with that run.
Come on. We're getting nothing. Guys, this actually isn't looking good.
Brandon, so many times we see the crossing route start as a quick hitter, but in this play, he had time in the pocket and waited for him to clear going across.
Nice.
He's got this one across midfield.
Good stop.
In the Cowboy territory. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him, so when you
come on,
to
baby.
Drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash.
Nice sack, Charlton.
And he will go down. Sack back in.
That's
the
46. Huge. All right, now I got to hold.
Taco Charlton.
Hold him.
In there to bring him down for a loss of 7.
Hold him, we got 2-minute offense.
They go play action with Wilson.
Let's go, baby. That's a great stop. Huge stop.
They've only converted one time thus far in this game, so you can see the frustration starting
that's
to come
a good
out
plan.
A little bit.
No, it's not.
Third downs, they've been a problem for them all.
It looked
game.
A lot better than it
they've
was. 2-minute warning. We got a minute and 66.
So a minute 56 to play in this first
half. This could
back
work.
To Century Link Field after this.
We might be able to hit a deep ball here.
First down, Prescott airing it out for Hearns.
That's a great defensive play.
Knocked away and incomplete.
Great defensive play.
Get it to Allen Hearns that time. That'll bring up second down. They don't get the hook up there, but you really have to marvel at how precise he's been throwing the football these last couple weeks.
Oh, that's the perfect word for it, precise. Because if you're at 70% or better, 2 weeks
no.
in a row.
Dude, he started coming up, so I was like, oh, he's going to get this. And then he backed up, and they played me. Played me good.
Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well.
The one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown him a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after him. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept him on their...
That's a pick. That's a batted pick, man. That's terrible. Got tipped and picked. We're making huge mistakes this game. That's a huge mistake.
And it's enough to rattle even the most seasoned of quarterbacks. And here, it looks like he's not quite on the same page as his receiver. This will wind up a turnover.
And that's off the mark, incomplete.
It's been my observation, there's been a nice variety of plays.
This is rough, boys.
You and I often talk about an offense as a
can't allow a touchdown. That's all we can allow.
With what they're doing. I think the converse has been true in this game.
Yeah, I think you're right. They seem to have gone off tendency quite a bit, but
they get ball back at half.
Quarter, a lot of time to change things.
I almost jumped
off
sides. Damn, dude.
And down inside
these kids are ridiculous.
First down, Seahawks. Wilson to Baldwin.
And it all came together there. In breaking route, drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
Now Wilson on first down. Forced out to his left. And he can't find a receiver.
There we go. That was a good play.
Jalen Smith able to run him down for a loss of a yard.
No doubt that's a very good play defensively right there.
All right, baby. Come on. We
got
to hold him.
He can take off and make a big play with his legs. How about the way they were able to contain him? That also tells me the coverage was excellent downfield.
To throw is Wilson. This will be caught at about the 6. And prior to this 3rd-and-2 play, we're going to get a timeout.
It's a huge play.
As they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in half number 1.
Let's stop him here.
Third and two. Now Wilson. Step under pressure now, and he's going to go down.
We're going to get the ball back down three, boys.
And now a timeout called by the Cowboys defense.
We got five sacks this game.
Just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. And Janikowski bangs
down four. I mean, down three with 40 seconds. All right, Tavon, get this ball out there. Let's return this. Why not? If anyone's going to return a kick, it's going to be Tavon. Bro, why does my joystick do that? Like that turn right there? I wasn't doing that.
By the way, I said bow tie. I meant just bow. Not the tie, but yeah.
Either way.
You got it.
I just went right past it.
Dak Prescott on the offense heading back onto the field. He's had a solid start to this game, but bottom line is they're losing. So, and the Seahawks defense.
That sucks.
And they bring him down. The best name in the NFL, Barkevious Mingo. And it'll make this a second and long.
Man, if I'm an offensive coordinator and I see an all-out rush like that, I file it away because I'm going to use their aggressiveness against them as this game goes on. I might hit them with a screen soon.
That is terrible. I lead that and I'm golden.
On the clock. Tyler Croft, the tight end, the one he was looking for. And now it's third down.
Well, nearly another interception there. That would have been two drives in a row with a pick.
Come on, baby.
He's going to take care of the ball way better than what we're saying.
Interestingly, that throw was probably worse than the one he threw the interception on last drive, but fell in. Oh, Prescott stripped. They're going to call another timeout as they stop it with 11 seconds.
That cannot hold on to the ball this game.
And now comes the Cowboys punter. Remember, though, he did have one blocked earlier.
Are you kidding me? What is that? Why are they blocking so many punts today? Why is that? No. Why is that a thing? Why are they allowing this to be a thing? I'm confused. Like, what is that? Their special teams team, the Seahawks special team is not this good. If they throw a touchdown right here, we're screwed. Thank the Lord. Jesus Christ, dude. We are getting so unlucky with these plays. I don't even know what's happening. I literally don't even know what's happening. Two punts have been blocked this game.
So we are at halftime here in downtown Seattle with the Seahawks out in front. Let's field it a few yards into the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25.
The end. Okay, well, I'll see you guys.